in. How is it going, everyone? Welcome to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. And today I want to play the DLC tracks. Well, four Deluxe, not the ones from the original Mario Kart 8, since those are included by default, and I already played them. But no, the actual DLC for this version of the game, which are... I need to first pick a character. Well, since I unlocked Gold Mario, I might as well, you know, pick him. I don't really mind the rest. I just want to show the... he still uses this? Whatever. So, the DLC tracks are these ones that you see here, though not all of them are available, since it's basically 6 waves of DLCs, and each wave has 2 cups. So the first wave is probably like these 2 cups, and then these 2, then these 2, right? But the ones that are not available are these 4, because these 4, well, these 2 belong to the 5th wave and this one to the 6th wave. And those will apparently come by the end of the year or something like that. I don't know if they are gonna come all together or separate, but whenever they come I will play them. But for now I will play the ones that are available, starting from the Golden Dash Cup. Sure. So, wait a second, I didn't check Gold Mario stats. What does this guy have? Can I change this without suffering too much? Doesn't seem like it. It seems like Golden Mario is, as expected, one of those heavy guys. I guess I could use this and then something like this. I don't know if it's the best idea, but I will try. Alright. So we start in Paris. Damn. Didn't expect they to use a real life location, but I think that Mario Odyssey uses a real life locations, right? It says tour. Oh, yeah, there is a Mario Kart game called I think Mario Kart something tour. I think. I don't know exactly what it is, though. But I think it's from whatever that is. Okay, we're in France. Oh, I thought it was the path. My bad. It was blocked off. Alright, that's not the path. Oh, don't go there. Damn, we just go through Eiffel Tower. Just like that. Don't think the security is gonna like that. And there is a piranha plant. Is there a piranha plant in Paris? Oh, this place was supposed to be... Damn, it's a very confusing track. Well, it's a very confusing track because it's an urban track. Usually in real life, urban tracks are also confusing if you don't know them beforehand. Because, I mean, urban tracks are things that are made on the spot. You basically put a track in a place that it's not supposed to have a track. Well, the biggest example being Monaco. The infamous track that happens in Formula 1. That track is an absolute disaster. Well, it's not an absolute disaster particularly because of not knowing where to go. I mean, after all, you know, Formula 1 drivers are professionals. They will clearly more than memorize the track before racing. But if you play that track in a video game, and you're just obviously a casual, you're gonna struggle hard because it's just... Oh wow, nice. Who was that? Oh, it was one of the Bowser Jr. guys. Hey Kyle, how is it going? Hey, I don't know what you say it means, but sure, I agree. But yeah, that's a French track. Well, if I'm not mistaken, Monaco is like a French don't know exactly what it is, like a... Like, I don't know what the word in English will be, but it's like a sub-country inside of France. Well, I'm not sure if the country is called Monaco or Monte Carlo. But yeah, they are in the inside of France. Also, how is it going, Drano? So, it seems that the DLC tracks can also be old tracks, because, well, this one was in Mario Kart 7. In fact, it was the very first track in Mario Kart 7. So, it's interesting. I don't know if I agree with that. Like, I know that nothing says that DLC tracks cannot be old tracks, but it feels a little bit weird to pay for a track that's been on a previous game additionally. Especially a track like this one. Because this track is, as I said, since it's the first track in Mario Kart 7, it's obviously a very basic track. I'm surprised that they have it as DLC. But on the bright side, Roy got in a bad position, so this is mine to take. And you know that, speaking of Gold Mario, I checked that other things you can unlock are also parts of the Golden Kart. There is a golden car that has a golden body, golden wheels, and golden glider. Each one unlocked in a different way. The problem is that I check multiple places, and except for the golden wheels, which everyone seems to agree how they are unlocked, every place tells me something different, so I don't know who to believe. Like, some say that to unlock the golden car you need to win every cup in 150cc and mirror mode with at least one star of ranking. Other people say that it's unlocked only by playing mirror mode and getting all of the, like, at least one star. And other people say that it's by playing every cup in every difficulty, so I really don't know who to believe. And for the glider, some people say that you need 10,000 coins, and some other people say 5,000. So I really don't know who to believe, and I'm surprised, because it's not like we're talking about some very obscure game from some very obscure console that only two people in the world played. We're talking about Mario Kart 8, you know? Like, not precisely an obscure game. And for some reason, everyone seems to say something different in how to unlock those things. But I don't know who to believe. Then again, between getting 5,000 and 10,000 coins, it doesn't really matter. Because it's just a matter of, you know, playing a lot regardless. The problem is the body, that if I need to also play the 150cc cups, I don't want to do it. But if it's only mirror mode, I don't mind doing it. So, that's part of the problem. Like, who do I trust? Like, even in a place like Reddit, that you know that a lot of people usually just, you know, tend to agree with each other in the same Reddit. In the same thread, they were saying different things. In the coconut mold. Alright, well, at least this is a cool track, but it's a little bit weird, because, see, the thing is that this track, not only it's an old track, but it's also a track that already came back in Mario Kart 7. So, yeah. I'm not very sure about these DLCs, if I gotta be honest. Obviously, having more tracks to play is always nice, but I'm a little bit concerned about the choices particularly. They don't really seem like the best choices you will make. Oh, and the cards now are being are being controlled by Shy Guys. Not to mention that the Shy Guys are also not going back and forth, but they are going... well, they are doing something weird. Like, they are... like, bragging about the hydraulics. Or hydraulics, whatever you call those. You know, those things that boost your car vertically. Like, they are not moving, they are just... Okay, never mind, one of them did move. I thought they were supposed to be Shy Guys. I don't think bragging about that sort of stuff is something that a Shy Guy will do, particularly. But hey, who am I to tell them what they can do? I don't remember there being columns like that in... Wow. Oh, he blocked that. Donkey Kong. And Donkey Kong gets the win. Alright. Oh, I also checked what are the conditions to get a star. Apparently to get a star in a cup, you need to win 2 races and get a score of at least 54. Which means that you can win 2 races and get second in the other 2 races. Or you could win 3 races and get 3rd place on the last race. Well, on the remaining race. I don't know if there are other combinations that will be possible. No, they are not. You wouldn't have enough points. No, those are the only combinations possible. Like, you either win 2 and get 2 second places, or you win 3 and get 1 third place. Well, or obviously win them all, but... yeah, that's a different story. Alright, it didn't went that bad with Gold Mario, though. Then again, these tracks are not very complex, and they are tracks that I already played, so... Okay, there is one new track, the last one. The last one is a new track in this cup. All of the other ones, though, seem to be returning tracks. This one in Mario Kart Tour. I don't remember in what console their Mario Kart Tour release. But yeah, I didn't play it. This one is called Tokyo Blur. Taking place in Paris, as you can see by the Eiffel Tower. I'm just kidding. It's not the Eiffel Tower, it's the Tokyo Tower. Oh, hit him! No! I need to head off at a reasonable time for the next 2 days, sadly. Yeah, that's fine. Don't worry about it. I mean... it happens. Good luck. Thank you. Well, if you're going to sleep, then good night. A good night with good dreams. Hope you dream about Gold Mario. Why would you want to dream about Gold Mario, you might ask? But then again, anything that is golden has to be good, right? If it's gold and shiny, how could it be bad? Uh-oh. Oh, it's okay, I have a banana peel, nice, got him. Yeah. The blue shell... you can grab that blue shell and shove it you know where. But yeah. Night night. Oh, also, if there is enough time today, I would like to play online. If I'm done with these 8 cups early, I can just play the rest online. So the Shroom Ridge, this is a cool track. Mario Kart, yes. Well, I mean, any kart? I mean a good track. Well, whatever. Point is that this is a good track because any track that has traffic is a good track by default. Like, the traffic just adds a layer of bullshit that feels great to overcome. Oh, you cannot go there. I thought I would be able to squeeze between the ridge and the signs, but no. You cannot do that. It ain't allowed. Alright. Ooh, that was very close. I'm also quite curious to see how this game plays at 150cc, because so far I played it in nothing but 200cc, and as you can see, more times than not, I'm kissing a wall. I would like to know what the intended way of playing the game is. Because 200cc apparently was added on a later update. So yeah. Question is how it feels to play at regular speed. Box. Nice. Good drift. On the outside. Toadette. Oh, then both Toad and Toadette are in the podium. Damn. Pretty. Sky Garden. Oh, the one from Game Boy Advance. This is a very good track. Well, probably my favorite of that game. Though here it probably looks nothing like. Like the one in Game Boy Advance, it's a little bit rework. But at the same time, as much as I like this track, I also feel a little bit weird that you included a track like this. Considering that this game, like it, the original tracks, one of them is a sky track, just like this one. Not to mention that it's also a sky track that features like this sort of stuff, like vines and obviously clouds. Though yeah, obviously that one is a lot more complex, but yeah. Well, I'm glad at least that they included it, just because, as I said, it's one of my favorites. In fact, I will say that they probably included almost all of my favorites in this game. Like, I think that's not a show. They probably included my favorites from every game. Oh, nice. Because from Super Mario Kart, my favorite is very clearly... Nice. It's very clearly Rainbow Road. From Mario Kart 64, my favorite is the one on the city, and they include that one. Well, from Super Circuit is this one. From Double Dash, it's the Daisy Cruise. Wait, did they include that one here? I don't remember if they include, because I know that they include that in Mario Kart 7, but I don't remember if they included it in this one. Well, whatever. Oh, Ninja Hideaway. So this is a new track. I don't know in... It's clearly based on ninjas, but I don't think it's based on any franchise in particular. It's just ninjas. Oh, yeah. The second kanji of that says shinobi. The first one, I have no idea. Maybe hideout or some shit, I don't know. But the second one means shinobi 100%. But at the same time, if I'm not mistaken, ninja, isn't ninja written with two kanjis? Like that you saw right there is the shinobi kanji, but now I don't remember how you're supposed to write ninja. Because shinobi you write it just by having that kanji, but ninja I think it's a two kanji word, and I don't remember the kanjis for that. As I say, I don't remember if one of the kanjis was not also the same kanji for shinobi. What I do know is that I'm getting fucked the ninja way. This is what Naruto meant by the ninja way. You're gonna get fucked like this. Damn. Guess Naruto had it rough. Oh, wrong side. Was turning right, but you needed to turn left. I feel like even with this result, I will win. But I didn't see the standing, so I don't know if this is actually a victory or not. I will assume it is, but if I keep doing this, it won't. Sixth place. Well, I hope it is a victory. Yeah, it is. Then by a lot. It's a shame that. Wait a second. If I got 53 points and I got sixth place, it's actually a lot more permissive. Like getting that star. Yeah, I guess I did the math wrong. Here I didn't get the star because I got 53 and not 54. But yeah, I guess I did the math wrong. Well, whatever. The stars here don't matter. It only matters in mirror mode and apparently in 150cc. I don't know, dude. I need confirmation of that. Since the internet doesn't want to agree. A button... Little bit weird to play on a button. But hey, sure, why not? Oh, they put Waluigi Pinball. Then I was about to say, I was talking about my favorite tracks. And I was about to mention DS. And yeah, Waluigi Pinball is my favorite one on DS. So I'm glad that they included it. In Mario Kart Wii... It's the Coconut Mall, and that is also included. New York Minute. And in Mario Kart 7, my favorite one is the musical one. So basically, they included all of my favorite tracks. It would be nice if they included the Rainbow Road from Mario Kart Wii. But this game already has two Rainbow Roads. So, I don't know if they are gonna do that, but then again, the game also has a lot of recycling in terms of previous returning tracks, so... Well, that's out of bounds, really? Okay. Wait, Why are these guys stopping at a green light? It is because they are Tatsu. Really? These urban circuits are... Like, if it's the first time you're playing them, it's very hard to play them properly. Well, not to mention that I'm pretty sure that the place you're supposed to go changes every lap, so... That makes it even harder. I'm getting fucked. I got fucked. Alright, I need to retry. That's fine. We can retry. We have a lot of time. And since there is only 8 cups, it's not gonna take as long as yesterday with those 12 cups. There are 4 less. Well, might as well change the character. I could use pink gold, bitch. Since we're using golden shit. Seems that the stats are relatively similar to Mario. To all Mario. I could use the button, I guess. Yeah, why not? And there is Mario Circuit 3 from SNES. Now, I wonder how these DLC tracks work online. Because if you play online, I will assume someone that doesn't have the DLC tracks wouldn't be able to play them. But if that's the case, that will also heavily limit the matchmaking. Or if it's something that you don't decide and it's instead based on the people that enter the lobby and checks who, like if everyone has the DLC, then the chances of playing a DLC track are very low. Because to have everyone in the lobby own the DLC, it's already quite a low chance. But yeah, I'm not sure how it works exactly. That's something that maybe I will find out today, or not, I don't know. Like maybe some of these cups are actually quite hard to play and they will take me some time. I don't know. It's impossible to know until I actually do it. When is that blue shell coming? I know you want to game. I know you are waiting for it. No blue shell. Also, this was surprisingly clean compared to the previous race. The previous race, I couldn't stop getting destroyed by items, and I ended like 10th place. I didn't end, I didn't even finish it. But a very classic Mario circuit. Well, this is gonna be a short track. But more importantly, at this speed, it's gonna be a nightmare to keep it up. Maybe not. Oh, okay, yeah. That corner is a problem. It seems that only that corner might be a problem. The rest seems relatively normal. I mean, their race just seems like a regular track. I mean, because at the end of the day, that's what Mario Circuit is. It's just a regular track. Doesn't have any bullshit. Doesn't have any bullshit other than the bullshit that already is present in Mario Kart, you know? Isabel, why are you going so fast? I can never remember if the name of this character is Isabel or Isabella. Because I care so little about Animal Crossing. Oh, it's Isabel. And I will always be pissed off that they included three Animal Crossing characters and they did not include Captain Falcon, dude. Oh, this track. The famous stopping track from Mario 64. Yeah, I don't know, dude. To me, it feels a little bit weird. I mean, I already paid for it, so it's not like it matters. But to me, it feels weird paying for these tracks, because they are not only returning tracks, but they are also returning tracks featured in previous games. Like this one, if I'm not mistaken, was featured in either in Mario Kart DS or Mario Kart 7, in one of those two. I don't remember exactly which one, but one of those two had this track. I'm a little bit... But the difference is that here you go to the rail tracks, which is something that you didn't do in the previous ones. They actually add something new. Oh! You also can get fucked by the... by the train. Alright, well, at least it has something new, but still. Feels a little bit weird to have them as DLC. Wait, that was the last lap? Really? I think that it was only one lap, actually. One lap with multiple sections. Then they really cut the Nintendo 64 tracks. And then Waluigi Pinball, the best track from Mario Kart DS. Problem is that it's also a hard track. If we're gonna go this fast, it's not gonna be easy, but we can try. I think that, well, this track was also featured in Mario Kart 7, so... I mean, I won't complain about this one because, as I said, it's my favorite one from Mario Kart DS. I can't complain about it being included here, but... yeah. It's another returning track that has already returned in a previous game. Maybe the issue is that they might have blown their load a little bit too early with Mario Kart 7. Because the track selection from Mario Kart 7 is just fantastic. They should have waited for this game to come out. But then again, in the year that Mario Kart 7 released, which I think it was 2000... wait, it can't be 2011, right? No, did the 3DS even exist back there? No. Has to be newer. I don't know exactly which year, but... Whatever year it was, it probably wasn't a year where the Switch was an idea. Or maybe it was an idea, but obviously it wasn't out yet. Especially these corners are hard to do in 200cc. They are pretty much not doable at full speed. That's fine. Nice, get on, Birdo. Alright. Very clean. Very, very clean. I won every single race of this cup. And coincidentally, none of these races had the anti-gravity gimmick. So I don't know. Maybe the anti-gravity gimmick is the one holding me back. Or not. Also, I always skip these highlights, but they might be cool. I don't know. And again, this highlight in particular seems to only be showing the last track. But yeah, no, it doesn't really have anything useful. And what happens when I get to the finish line? Do you repeat? Yeah, it repeats, I guess. Alright. So this is 3 whole stars. I have 500 coins. Nice. Alright, on to the next cup. The next cup should also be part of the second DLC wave, right? Oh nice, the Cloud Glider. I was talking about this one yesterday. This one is perfect for Lucky 2. I guess I can also use it here. So the Propeller Cup. Oh, and there is a new track at the end of this one. And there is also, it seems that all of these cups are gonna start with a Mario Kart Tour cup. This one is in Sydney. None other, well, so far we got France, the USA, Japan, and Australia. Very safe picks. I wonder if they are more daring and they actually pick a not so popular country. So if I had to guess, they are probably gonna pick Italy, probably the UK, maybe even Brazil. And I don't know what other country they could include. Will be interesting if they included Spain. And when it comes to famous countries, you usually think of those. Like the usual, USA, France, Australia, the UK. Damn it. Oh, I got fucked. Italy, Japan. Those are the popular ones. When I say popular ones, it's because they are featuring media a lot. Well, China is also popular, but sometimes Japanese games don't include it when they are about global stuff. In fact, I wonder if there is gonna be another Asian country being featured. I doubt that they will put Korea. I don't know if they put Russia at some point. But keep in mind that some of this DLC released before this whole thing happening now with Russia, right? So Russia is a possibility. But yeah, I don't know. But yeah, so far these are very safe choices. But yeah, as I say, the next ones I expect are the UK and Italy. So Snowland on the Game Boy Advance. I don't remember this one. I actually don't remember this one. But then again, most of the ice tracks I don't remember. Because to me they are... they are not very different between each other, you know. I also don't remember if they had penguins in them. Maybe they did, maybe they didn't, I don't know. Hey, a lot of these old tracks in this particular game, they are super reworked. Well, they are not really the tracks that you might be used to. And again, I don't know how many people really played Super Circuit so much, because I think that of all the Mario Kart games, Super Circuit might be the least popular one, right? Because Super Mario Kart was the first one, so I can imagine it being quite popular. Mario Kart 64 is pretty much a game that anyone that owned a Nintendo 64 probably played. What about Mario Kart Advance? Mario Kart Super Circuit on the Game Boy Advance. Was that played by many people? I mean, how many people even had the Game Boy Advance, right? Like, I don't think it was as popular of a console as the DS, for example. Well, Double Dash, I'm assuming it's quite popular since it's, you know, a game that introduced a lot of changes that are pretty much still used to this day. Mario Kart DS was probably popular just because the DS was popular. Mario Kart Wii was insanely popular. Mario Kart 7 is the question, but then again, I will assume Mario Kart 7 being more popular than Super Circuit. I mean, there are people that to this day they played on an emulator with a mod so they can play online. Well, in fact, when I was playing it, someone was telling me to do that. Obviously, I didn't want to do it, but they were telling me as an option. Wow, that guy got in front of that green shell. Pretty nice to tank that hit for me. I think that was Dry Bowser. Very, very nice of you, Mr. Bowser. That corner is tough. Also, this is yet again another track that has already been featured on Mario Kart 7 as a returning track, even with that blue mushroom gimmick. So yeah, I will say that it's a weird choice of tracks. This one, at least, the one that comes now, is at least new. Something about Sky High Sunday. Well, it's very similar to another track that is introduced in this game. That is also about sweets. I mean, it's still original because it has sweets in it, but We already have one here. Oh, nice. Seems that the gravity... Well, we have the anti-gravity things all the time. Like, during this track, not a single time the anti-gravity wheels have disappeared. The whole track happens with this for some weird reason. Well, I'm not complaining, but... Seems like a weird decision. But see, not a single time. Even when you start the race, you already start with the anti-gravity wheels. Alright. Why not? Didn't know it wasn't gonna reach me. It's alright. For them. They stole my red shell. I don't need it anyways. Yeah, but this was a pretty fun track. I mean, this is pretty much an oval track. Like, it has some corners that might make you think that it's more complex or whatever. But it's essentially an oval track like the side bike track. But pretty cool, I like it. Well, probably because it was so simple. You can go extremely fast, like it's no issue. Yeah, it was a cool track, I enjoyed it. It was nice. It did its job. And I didn't lose a single race yet again. Alright, on to the next one. This one will be Wave 3 of DLC. So let's see. I'm gonna keep picking this character. I mean, after all, I'm doing well. It's the Rock Cup, and it goes to London. As I said, very obviously it was gonna be in the UK. And I swear the next one is gonna be in Italy. They are checking all the obvious ones. All the obvious ones, they are just checking them. But yeah. I guess after Italy, maybe Mexico, I guess. Like, we're talking about super popular countries. And yeah, I will say that both Mexico and Brazil are quite popular. When you talk about global destinations, you usually think of those on top of the ones that already showed up, I mean, obviously. Because Spain could be one of them, but I don't know. I don't know how much people really care about Spain. So I mean, differently from this type of countries, is there really a place in Spain that is like a touristic attraction? Because for example, in the UK here you have the Big Ben and the Thames River or whatever it's called. Right, like, and London itself, it's obviously, like, regardless of what London might have or might not have, London in itself is extremely popular because of how much media takes place there. But when it comes to Spain, is there really a place that you could say this is the place everyone thinks about? I don't know. I mean, you have Madrid, the capital city, obviously, but... Do you have any place in particular that comes to your mind when thinking about Spain? I personally don't. Track with bulls? Well, yeah, I was thinking of bulls, but see, that's the thing. First of all, most people understandably don't like that, including myself, of course. So I wouldn't think that if you think about Spain, you will think about bull runs. But even if you think about that, there is not really a specific place for that. I mean, yeah, it doesn't happen in the whole country. It happens in some specific places, but it's not like you will say like the name of a place immediately, right? Bull Lake from Super Circuit. I also don't remember this one. I don't remember this one because boot tracks are largely pretty much the same thing. Anytime that I see a boot track, I just... yeah, it's a boot track, indeed. I like them, though. I'm not saying that I dislike them, but... yeah, boot tracks are usually very similar to each other. It's when you actually go underwater, which is something that you obviously don't do in Super Circuit. But yeah. I don't know. Which other country will you say, Kyle, that has global appeal? Because so far, we had USA, Japan, the UK, France, and what was the other one? Oh yeah, Australia. So I was thinking about Italy, Mexico, and Brazil. As the kind of places that people will think about when it comes to tourism. But which other places will come to your mind? I don't know. I really can't think of many others. I guess some people will say China, but you really want to go to China for tourism? I don't know about that. Well, before the war, a lot of people will probably mention Moscow in Russia. But yeah. I don't know. I don't think I can think of that many. A track on the pyramid. Okay. A ship. Yeah, that's not a bad idea. I mean, a ship is also the kind of destination that a lot of people will think when it comes to tourism. Yeah, good point. Yeah, a ship will definitely be one of them. Alright, yeah, I didn't think of that. But yeah. But you know, the point is that... obviously, those are the predictable places, but I wish they used less predictable places, you know? Because so far, all the places they have used are the most safe, generic choices you could think of. Why don't you put a track on Kazakhstan? Hey, come on, cowards. Put a track on Kazakhstan and see what happens. Dubai? Well, Dubai has been gotten pretty popular lately. Considering that the oil money they have is quite ridiculous. But yeah, I guess the Arab Emirates wouldn't be a bad choice, but... yeah, it could be. Ah, that really didn't count. No, the Chapin track, we already had a Chapin track, and no, it wasn't in the Suicide Forest, it was as it was expected in Tokyo. See, that's the problem, because it's not just that the country choice is generic, but also the city choice is generic. USA was New York. UK was London. Japan was Tokyo. France was Paris. And Australia was Sydney. Like, the most generic choices possible. I mean, obviously this game is not about travel. It's about racing, so it is to be expected that they will have those choices. But yeah. Like, I would like to call them basic bitch choices. Because they really are. I don't like using the expression basic bitch, but how else will you call them? They really are. If they include one of those tourism tracks in every one of the DLC cups, though, there is a total of 12 DLC cups. So I feel like there will have to be one country that will have to be unexpected. The question is which one. Well, then again, unexpected is a way of saying, because I feel like a country like Spain will be unexpected in the sense that it usually is not in the focus, like the first choice when it comes to touristic attractions, but like, come on. It's still a very popular country. Damn it. Oops. Will be nice if they actually say no. You know what? Let's put Portugal. We're gonna go to the Well, I don't know how this word is pronounced. I think it's Iberian Peninsula, right? I don't know. Something like that. Well, basically Portugal and Spain. But yeah, it would be nice if instead of picking Spain, they will pick Portugal. It would be an interesting change of pace, because I feel like Portugal in media is not featured at all. At least I don't remember it being featured even once in media. Well, not like I consume a ton of media in general. But I... Oh wow, I fucked myself up, nice. Very good. I don't know why I threw the bomb there, not like it was gonna do anything anyways. My bad. Also, this is the kind of track that playing on 200cc will be a problem. I remember that this track was already a little bit hard to properly properly steer in the corners without getting fucked in the Wii version. But yeah, here that we're going that fast, it's even worse. Okay, so if you get third place, you get 10 points. That means you get to 55, but if you get 4th place, you get 9. So in theory, it should be possible. If you win 3 races, if you want to at least get 1 star at the end, you could get 4th place. I don't know if you can get 5th place, though. You shouldn't, because it shouldn't give the same amount of points as... You know. Shouldn't give the same amount of points as 5th place. Sorry, as 4th place. Oops. Sorry. I'm drunk. I'm drunk with victory. This is what happens. When you win too much, you get drunk on it. Wait, am I playing the tracks in order, by the way? Yeah, I am. I'm gonna keep picking this character. I mean, she's doing pretty well. One is called Retro Off-Road. But yeah, no thanks. Alright, so on to this one. Damn, barrel. Okay! So I say that I say that the next one was gonna be in Italy, but they actually chose Germany. I didn't even mention Germany. I wasn't expecting... I mean, Berlin, I guess it is a... like a very touristic attraction, but I wouldn't say that Berlin is more attractive touristically than it than Rome, for example. Right? I mean, what do you even have in Berlin? Aside from the broken wall that they probably keep for, you know, memorial purposes. The wall that, by the way, I'm pretty sure it is in here. Like, if you saw the intro, you could see the wall being covered by some stone guys. Which is funny. I don't know. Then again, I guess you could also consider this a safe choice. Because Germany is, you know, for better or for worse, is one of the most popular European countries. So yeah, I guess it makes sense. But yeah, I don't know. I wouldn't have picked it. Because I feel like it's a choice that... it's obviously not an obscure choice, but it's not like one of the first things that I will think of as an... like as an international track. But then again, maybe I'm underestimating how popular tourism is in Berlin. Maybe it's actually a lot more popular than I give it credit for. But yeah, I think that what you should saw there to the right was supposed to represent the wall. Maybe. I mean, there is a wall and we're in Berlin, so I'm assuming that it is that wall. Got him. Nice. Blue shell and it didn't reach me. Hey Yannick, how is it going? Yeah, I'm using gold pitch. And we are driving in international track. So far, we got USA, UK, France, Australia. Well, Germany, which is the one that you should saw. And Japan. Pitch Gardens on the DS. This is another track that came back on the Wii. Yeah. I don't know. I don't want to sound negative. I really feel like the DLC choices for this game, like, these are good tracks. Like, I'm not saying they are bad tracks, but it just feels weird that they make you pay for them as DLC, considering, you know, they've been featured multiple times in other Mario Kart games. Did the US track have burgers? Well, I didn't see any burger place. It was New York at night. But yeah, I don't think I saw burgers. But hey, I also didn't see guns. So yeah. It's that they wanted... They wanted a more... normal presentation, I guess. I guess you have to think of these DLC tracks as convenience. Because sure, you could say that these tracks are in other Mario Kart games multiple times. But, I mean, if you play a Mario Kart game now, you will be playing this one. So having them all on this game, where they also obviously have online compatibility, then we're going backwards? What the hell? I think that we're going the same way that they came. Like, I mean, they are clearly not the exact same tracks. You can tell that there are some gimmicks attached to them, but... I guess the issue would be if they ever release... Oh, I fucked up. Damn it, I thought for sure that you needed to go... I thought that you needed to go to the left. I had no idea you were supposed to steer right. It didn't look like it. Also, I have no idea where Baby Mario was. I know that Metal Mario overtook me, but I didn't see Baby Mario on the minimap. We have a Merry Mountain. It's a Christmas theme track, and the first Christmas theme track in Mario Kart. So this one is quite original. Well, it's obviously a new one, so we'll say that it's original by definition. But yeah, pretty cool. But yeah, I was about to say, like, the inclusion of these tracks that are repeated in other games, I guess it will be a problem if there are other Mario Kart games in the future. That's the thing, this game has so much content that I don't feel there's gonna be another Mario Kart game in the future. And if there is, it's gonna be pretty hard to make it better than this one, you know? Like, I feel like they will still port Mario Kart 8, but obviously if they do that, I don't know, well, they wouldn't get too much money, or maybe they would. I mean, if they just keep porting the game, they will have an infinite revenue, essentially. But yeah, if they release another one, that's the issue, because a lot of these tracks, if they release Mario Kart 9 and they also put DLC tracks on that game, most of the tracks are gonna be repeated on this game. Since this game already repeats track, you can tell that they won't hesitate to keep repeating them. Wow, that's bad. But yeah, I don't know. Then again, if this is your only Mario Kart game, like the first and only Mario Kart game that you played, having pretty much the best tracks from every Mario Kart game in the past is the best thing you could ask for. So they decided to add Rainbow Road from 3DS. That's a shame. I don't dislike this track, but I would have preferred if they included a Rainbow Road from Wii. Now, the problem is that with this Rainbow Road, we already have three Rainbow Roads in the game. So I feel like it's gonna be a little bit hard for them to include Rainbow Road on the Wii. I mean, it's a possibility, especially since I'm assuming a lot of people like that specific Rainbow Road. But yeah. Having three Rainbow Roads, well, maybe they will include it on the last DLC wave, because this is the last track of DLC wave 3, which means that pattern wise you could expect the last track of DLC wave 6 to also be a Rainbow Road. Now, whether that Rainbow Road is the one on the Wii or not, I don't know. But then again, I feel like it will be a little bit of a waste if you include the Rainbow Road of Super... Well, the Rainbow Road on Super Circuit is basically like an easy version of the Rainbow Road in Super Mario Kart. This should be my victory, because the ones that are in front of me are Wario and regular Mario. So that shouldn't be a problem. Well, if I win, obviously it won't. Oh, there you have it. Mario Kart will become Street Fighter and make everyone DLC. Of course. Well, they already make... Well, I'm pretty sure Birdo is a DLC character in this game, which is fucked up because Birdo was featured in Double Dash. And that also brings me to the other thing I was about to say. The Rainbow Road in Double Dash and in Mario Kart DS are like the one in Mario Kart Wii, but easier and less exciting. They are not bad, but I feel like if you're gonna include another Rainbow Road, it has to be the one on the Wii. Like, you already included the one in... Wait, actually, they also included the Rainbow Road from Mario Kart 64. Which means that there is actually 4 Rainbow Roads so far. In that case, then yeah, they have to include... you have to include the one on the Wii. Damn, Amsterdam? Really? We're going to the Netherlands. I wasn't expecting that. Then again, Amsterdam is a popular tourist attraction, I guess. But then... Well, another messed up stuff is that except for USA and Japan, well, and Australia, but I mean, all of the other ones are Europe. Like, I understand that Europe is basically the main touristic continent in the world, but come on. Besides, Amsterdam. Like, you're showing the windmills, because what else will you show? Oh, that's the wrong way. See, Amsterdam, I mean... I don't know, dude. Those Amsterdam, like, I understand that they are... particular things in Amsterdam that you might find attractive, like for example the fact that they have legal prostitution, right? Yeah, pretty cool. But the thing is that when you think of a touristic spot, like, I don't know, but yeah, when you say Amsterdam, I know what city you're talking about, but if you tell me a specific place of Amsterdam is... I don't know. Can dodge taxes. Yeah. Religious activity. Yeah, pretty religious. But yeah, I don't know, dude. I don't feel like Amsterdam is a good choice, particularly. Riverside Park, I also don't remember this track from Game Boy Advance, but then again, this version probably looks nothing like the one on Super Circuit anyways. You get a religious appointment. you will first probably need to be Shintoist. Oye, no. I don't know, I feel... prostitution aside... I feel like if you're gonna choose... Like... I feel like... places like Beijing... or whichever city that has the Taj Mahal in India... which I don't know if it's New Delhi or if it's a different place. Not a particular Indian connoisseur, but I mean... Wait, no, Taj Mahal is in Bangkok, isn't it? It's not in the India. Wait, my bad, sorry. Sorry, Indian bros. I'm a little bit ignorant. But yeah, that would probably be a... that would probably be a better... idea for a destination than, well, a destination, I mean, a track in this game than Amsterdam. Like, come on, bro, if you're gonna include a boring city like that, at least include a boring city that is uncommon. Like, I don't know, include, what example I could give you? Why don't you include Asunción in Uruguay, right? Wait, I'm stupid. Paraguay. Today my brain is not worldwide wire. No, Uruguay will be Montevideo. Sorry. Damn it. I'm confusing the cities like an absolute idiot. But yeah, like, the point is, if you wanted to include a boring city, at least you could include an original boring city. You know? Hey Delta, how is it going? Well, yeah, I know that they are doing popular cities. But the thing about popular cities, I know that Amsterdam is popular, but I mean, at least in my opinion, Amsterdam is a boring city. Like, if you want to include a popular city that to me wouldn't be boring, why don't you include Rio de Janeiro, for example? I can understand Russian and Chinese cities not being included, but hey, Brazil is not in political. They are in political heat with themselves, but I mean, not worldwide. Wow, nice, very good bomb. About that, oh. So they actually put Rio de Janeiro in the game? It's a 50-50 chance to appear. Wow, what the hell are you doing, Lucky 2? Alright. Lucky 2, are you drunk? Damn, that was bad though. Fifth place is terrible. I probably will have to redo this tourney. Oh, the ones that go the first place. No, I can still win. I can still win. Yeah, Lucky 2 420. Lucky 2 was doing some weird stuff. But yeah, another popular city that you could include is Bangkok. You know? More likely than a 50-50, its only competition is Seoul. Well, they could also include... Well, Seoul will be nice because you don't usually see Korea being portrayed as a touristic attraction. So it will be cool. But yeah, another one will also be either Toronto or Vancouver. Probably Vancouver. Like, if we're talking about Canada, I would say that Vancouver is the better option. Not to mention that there is already a Mario game that includes Vancouver, which is Sonic and Mario on the Olympic Winter Games. A very interesting game that I actually have on the Wii. Vancouver is already confirmed. Oh, nice. Well, see, that's a good choice. I will approve of that. I personally... The only choices that I don't like are Germany... Well, Germany. Berlin, which, yes, is in Germany, but I mean the track is Berlin. But yeah, Berlin and Amsterdam are two choices I don't like. Because... You already have quite a lot of European representation, and you add two cities that, at least to me, if you're like making it in a fantasy environment like Mario Kart is, like, they are very boring choices, you know. Like, I agree with Paris, and I also agree with London. Those are good choices. But yeah, Amsterdam and Berlin, it's like... no. Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying that I dislike the track. I just don't like the idea of including that location. Like, the tracks are okay, like, whatever. But having them being the choice is what I feel that... That makes no sense. But yeah, it's alright. Berlin is lame to play? Maybe. Alright, there is only one more DLC cup remaining. Which I wonder what's gonna have. Earlier I say that Rome was a very clear choice to be included, and it most likely will be. But let's see. Crimson Slim. No. Get me back to the button. It's actually Bangkok Dim! So I actually guessed that one right. See? That's a good choice. Good stuff. Bangkok, it's something that I always get confused. It's in Thailand, right? If I'm not mistaken. Or is it in another country? Was it in Thailand? I know the touristic spot, but... Like, I always get confused from which country it is. I think it is Thailand, right? Rome is very unlikely. Well, that would be a shame, because if we're talking about European cities that could be fun to drive, it could be that one. Yeah, this is Thailand, and I can recognize that because of the statue in the background being resting in the ground. That's 100% Thailand. Yeah, no doubt. With data mines, we know what the remaining cities are, except for one. Interesting. Well, what I do want to see, aside from this international tracks, as I was saying earlier, I want to see Rainbow Road from the Wii. But yeah, with how many Rainbow Roads we have already, I feel like it will probably be hard to tell if that's the case. Oh, damn, I actually got it. I'm in luck. Oh, damn, it's gonna be included. And that's great. A remaining city starts with a P, an R, or an S. Oh, so that's why you say that Rio de Janeiro could be there. If it starts with S... Well, I don't know. It will be interesting if it was Shanghai. Oh, also, since you seem to know about this game, Delta, I have a question for you. So, you know that I've been checking the unlockables of the game, and essentially the unlockables are Gold Mario and the parts for the Golden Card. So, my question is, because every place seems to say something different, like, no page seems to agree. How do you unlock the Kart body? Because some pages say that you need to beat every mirror cup with one star. Some other pages say that you need to beat 150cc and mirror with one star. And some other pages say that you need to beat all of the difficulties with one star. So what's the one that's right? Because I haven't seen one page. It's just mirror. Oh, really? And so why are there so many pages that say 150 and mirror? Because that's something that, like, of the options that I saved, that's the one that shows up the most. For some reason. Don't ask me why. Yeah. Interesting. So, another question I have is the glider. Does it get unlocked with 5,000 coins? Or 10,000 coins? Because some people say 10,000, some other people say 1,000. Sorry, 10,000. Like 5,000 or 10,000. So I don't know which one it is. Oh, in the Wii U version, it was 150 and mirror, I see. Yeah, I guess that will explain it. 5,000 in Deluxe, alright. 10,000 in Wii U, alright. Well, thanks a lot for the information. I'm really glad I asked you because, as I say, there every place says something different, and they don't particularly specify if it's on Wii U or on Switch. Well, some of them do, but some others don't. Deluxe is for casuals? You think so? It might be. But yeah. In that case, I can definitely do it. I mean, the glider is obviously not something that I'm gonna actively farm. But the body and the wheels, I can definitely get them. I'm pretty sure that's something that I'm probably gonna do on the next streams. Probably gonna try to get to get the wheel first and the body later, probably. The issue is that they are in 150cc, that's the issue. You know? So like, all this time I'm getting used to 200cc, but now I have to get used to... Well, getting used to 150 is not a problem because it's slower. If anything, it should be easier to do it. But the issue will be getting used to 200 again. I'm sure it's gonna be fine. But yeah. I want to get them. But it shouldn't be a challenge. Well, maybe the time trials could be a challenge. I mean, I don't know how hard they can get, but if they are like the ones in Mario Kart 7, they are not hard. Because you only need to beat the dev time. You don't have to beat... Wait, Singapore? I didn't expect another international track here. Alright. Interesting. Wait, isn't Singapore a country? Shouldn't it say the name of the city? Or maybe we are going through multiple cities. Well, see, this is also a cool choice. Singapore is a city-state, it's a city and a country at the same time. I see. I guess that makes sense. Good luck with Belo Ghost. No, but you don't understand. Belo Ghost will be the Edsper Ghost. What I need to be are basically the Entropy Ghost. You know? So that shouldn't be a problem. But yeah, I probably want to do that tomorrow. I'm not sure what to do first, but I feel like it's a better idea to do the time trials first, since they are not mirrored, and then do the mirror mode with all the stars. I feel like that's probably the best idea. At the same time, though, I want to get the... Oh, that's unlucky. Want to get the gold car body more than the golden wheels, but I feel like leaving mirror mode for last is gonna be the best. So I don't get used to mirror mode before the time trial. Nice. Beautiful. Well, that was free. I feel like a lot of these tracks were a lot easier than the main base tracks. But that's probably because the tracks here are probably taking into account the 200cc. Like a lot of the other tracks in the base game were not really made with 200cc in mind, so it was a lot harder to win. But this one, I got it extremely fast. Like, extremely fast. But yeah. I guess, well, I'm not forgetting any DLC, right? Like, that's the last one available for what I know. They let me double check just in case. Yeah, that's the last one, because these ones are about to, yeah. There you have it. Say it will be available by the end of 2023. It says the same thing with this one, so. Well, that was the DLC tracks available for the moment in 200cc, so, shishis.